Water and hydrogen bonding, topic 1.1 of this AP Biology review. This is Mr. W from learn-biology.com, where we believe that the kind of learning you need to succeed in AP Bio requires interaction and lots of feedback. That's what we provide on learn-biology.com. Your subscription comes with a money-back guarantee. First thing to note is that water is a polar molecule. There's unequal electron sharing between oxygen and hydrogen. And so there's a partial negative region over here. There's partial positive regions over here, delta negative, delta positive. Note that hydrogen bonds are intermolecular bonds. They're between molecules, not within molecules like covalent bonds or ionic bonds or anything like that. So what's happening is that the oxygen is partially negative, the hydrogen is partially positive, and the hydrogen bond is a weak bond that forms between those two areas. Hydrogen bonds are much weaker than covalent bonds, ionic bonds, any of those intramolecular bonds. Using the diagram below as an example, describe how hydrogen bonds can form between molecules besides water. The key idea is that hydrogen bonds are everywhere. They're not just within water. They're essential in biology in general. So in this example, there are two hydrogen bonds, and here's one oxygen to hydrogen over here. Here's another one between nitrogen and hydrogen. This is between the nitrogenous base adenine and thymine. And these are the hydrogen bonds that hold together DNA. Hydrogen bonds, again, are essential. They're key to the structure of DNA, RNA, proteins. You'll meet them again and again throughout your biology course, and they're important to know for the AP Bio exam as well. So now let's look at some of the consequences. So describe cohesion, adhesion, and surface tension, and explain how these key properties of water result from hydrogen bonding. Cohesion, that's hydrogen bonds between water molecules. So this is cohesion right here. And it's responsible for many of water's very peculiar properties. It's a very small molecule, but it has a very high heat of vaporization. It takes a lot of energy to get water to evaporate, a high specific heat. It can hold a lot of heat, and it has high surface tension, which we'll talk about below. Adhesion is water sticking to other stuff. So like, for example, here you see hydrogen bonds between water molecule and the cellulose walls that make up the conductive tubes of plants, which are also called xylem. And it's also responsible for a phenomenon called capillary action, where water can actually go up for a short distance the sides of a straw as the water molecules bond with the plastic or the cellulose that makes up that straw. And a phenomenal thing is called transpiration, which is how water gets pulled up to the top of trees. And that's all based on water's ability to cohere to other water molecules and to adhere to the sides of the conductive tubes of plants as water evaporates from the top. And finally, surface tension. Here we see a paperclip that's resting on a net of water molecules. And of course, that's ridiculously out of scale. You can see how that's keeping this paperclip from sinking down. And here it's the force exerted by water molecules on the surface of a body of water creates a kind of web or net upon the surface. At learn-biology.com, we understand why students struggle with AP Bio. It's a hard course, but we have a plan for your success. Go to learn-biology.com, sign up for a free trial, and complete our interactive tutorials and interactive AP Bio exam reviews. We guarantee you a 4 or 5 on the AP Bio exam. See you on learn-biology.com. In terms of hydrogen ions, hydroxide ions, and pH, describe the difference between an acidic and a basic solution. First thing to note is that acidic solutions are solutions that have more hydrogen ions. Here's a hydrogen ion over here than hydroxide ion. That's represented by OH over here. So if you dissolve this in water, you wind up having lots of hydrogen ions, and that pushes the pH down, all right? The pH is below 7. In bases, there are more hydroxide ions than hydrogen ions. So if you dissolve sodium hydroxide in water, you wind up with a lot more hydroxide ions, and that pushes the pH in this direction. pH is above 7. And one thing that I want to emphasize is that you don't really need to know about pH for the AP exam directly. There won't be a question about it, but it might be part of an FRQ or a multiple choice question. So it's an essential underlying concept. Want to learn more? Sign up for a free trial of the website that guarantees your AP Biology success. Learn-biology.com and watch this next video.